A group of scientists from Google and Harvard University have managed, for the first time in human history, to read and understand how memories are formed in the human brain. This revolutionary experiment has been conducted on a relatively small strain of brain, but helped the scientists to move to bigger and more important parts of the brain in the future and to potentially treat neurological issues such as insomnia and depression, as those can only really be treated by understanding their causes inside of the human brain. Welcome to today's episode of AI News. In this episode, I will show you what has been accomplished in the field of neuroscience, what good this will do very soon, and the ways this will benefit the emerging field of brain-computer interfaces. Google and Harvard researchers produced a comprehensive map of every cell and connection in a cubic millimeter of the human brain at the beginning of last month. The cerebral cortex is a portion of brain tissue involved with higher-level cognition, such as thinking, planning, and language. The mapped region includes the many layers and cell types of the cerebral cortex. It is the largest brain map at this level of detail to date, according to Google, and has been made freely available for scientists and the general public to reiterate upon. The human brain is an enormously intricate network of brain cells that is responsible for all human behavior, but we haven't been able to map these connections completely inside even a tiny section of the brain until now. The researchers created the map by slicing donor tissue into 5,330 nanometer thick pieces and imaging them with a scanning electron microscope with a resolution of 4 nanometers. The 225 million pictures that resulted were computationally aligned and stitched together to create a 3D digital depiction of the area. Humans checked the work of machine learning algorithms that segmented cells and categorized synapses, axons, dendrites, cells, and other structures. Last year, Google and the Howard Hughes Medical Institute's Genelia Research Campus made news when they mapped a part of a fruit fly brain in a similar way. That map, which was the biggest of its kind at the time, covered 25,000 neurons and 20 million synapses. The new map covers tens of thousands of neurons and 130 million synapses, in addition to addressing the human brain, which is notable in and of itself. It occupies 1.4 petabytes of hard drive space. In instance, NASA's Landsat program requires 1.3 petabytes of storage to store 3 decades worth of satellite photographs of Earth. On the lowest sizes, a collection of brain pictures is like a planet in a grain of sand. All of this is, however, a millionth of a human brain. That is to say, a comparable comprehensive map of the entire situation will take years. Nonetheless, the work demonstrates how quickly the area is evolving. A map with this level of information and size would have been unthinkable only a few decades ago. Connectomics is the study of the brain's cellular circuitry. The human connectome, or the entire brain's wiring architecture, is a moonshot on par with the human genome. And, like the human genome, it appeared unachievable at first. Only two simple organisms have full connectomes, the nematode worm and the larva of C. intestinalis, a marine monster. There's a compelling explanation for this. Until recently, mapping was a time-consuming and expensive procedure. In the 1980s, researchers mapping C. elegans used a film camera linked to an electron microscope to photograph slices of the worm, then manually rebuilt the neurons and synaptic connections, like a frustratingly complex three-dimensional jigsaw. Although C. elegans only contains 302 neurons and about 7,000 synapses, the rough draft of its connectome took 15 years to complete, and the final draft took another 20. Clearly, this method would not be scalable. So, what's new? To put it in a short way, automation. The photos themselves are, of course, digital these days. Each slice of tissue is shaved down a few nanometers at a time using a technique known as focused ion beam milling. An electron microscope scans the freshly exposed layer when one layer is vaporized. The ion beam shaves away the photographed layer, and the next one is scanned, until the slice of tissue is reduced to a nanometer resolution digital copy. It's a long way from the Kodachrome era. What occurs after scientists finish that stack of photos, though, may be the most significant advance. Algorithms take control instead of humans putting things together. Their initial task is to place an order for the photographed slices. Then they accomplish something that was previously unthinkable until the last decade. They carefully align the pictures, following the flow of cells and synapses between them, to create a 3D model. Humans still proofread the findings, but they are no longer responsible for the most difficult part. Even the proofreading process may be improved. Sebastian Sung, a well-known neuroscientist and proponent of connectomics, for example, invented iWire, a game in which hundreds of volunteers evaluate structures. The algorithms can trace neurons quicker than the researchers can generate picture data. Sung informed the audience at a TED presentation in 2010 that you're your connectome. Rebuild the connections, and you'll rebuild the mind as a whole, memories, experiences, and personality. However, connectomics has sparked debate throughout the years. Some argue that mapping the connectome at this degree of detail is not required for a thorough knowledge of the brain. Researchers were concerned that the magnitude of resources necessary would not provide comparable, valuable, or timely findings, especially in the field's early, more artisanal days. We don't need to know the precise details of the wiring of each cell and each synapse in each of those brains. What we need to know, instead, is the organizational principles that wire them together. These, the scientists believe, can likely be inferred from observations at lower resolutions. Furthermore, a static image of the brain's physical connections may not always reflect how those connections are used in practice. When he initially began out, a renowned expert in the area calculated that painstakingly tracing all the connections in a cubic millimeter of human brain would take a million years. He went on to say that the entire brain would take a trillion years to process. That is why algorithms and automation have been so important in the industry. Since they started working on the fruit fly connectome in 2008, Jerry Rubin and his colleagues have witnessed a 1,000-fold boost in mapping speed. The whole connectome, of which the first section was finished last year, might be completed in 2022. Other research groups are focusing on other species, such as octopuses, with the hope of uncovering new information by examining how various types of intelligence are linked together. By the end of the decade, the entire connectome of a mouse, which is now underway, may have followed the fruit fly. According to Rubin, jumping from mouse to human would need a million-fold increase in mapping speed. However, he cites the trillion-fold increase in DNA sequencing speed since 1973 as evidence that such huge technological advancements aren't unheard of. In another perspective, the genome may be a good analogy. Even after the first human genome was sequenced, it took several years to scale genomics to the point where its full promise could be realized. Perhaps connectomics will be the same way. Brain maps, according to proponents, will provide new insights into how the brain functions, from thinking to emotion and memory, as well as new ways to diagnose and treat brain diseases. Others, including Google, are likely hoping to get insights that will lead to more efficient computers and more powerful artificial intelligence. It's impossible to predict what scientists will discover as they map the inner workings of our thoughts neuron by neuron, synapse by synapse, but it appears that big discoveries are almost guaranteed. So what is your opinion on the brain, becoming more and more researched as time goes on? Do you think the benefits of potentially being able to cure neurological disorders outweigh the potential privacy concerns of devices being able to read what we think? Please tell us your opinion in the comment section below. I would love to hear what you have to say about it. Thank you for watching AI News. We consistently report on the newest technologies that are shaping the future of our world. We'd appreciate you subscribing and watching our other videos. See you around and take care.